Hi, good morning. We are in New York today. WISeKey just finalized the WISeKey USA board meeting. It's the first inaugural meeting on a group of people that they're helping WISeKey to enter into the US market. The main focus of the company during the next 12 months in the United States is fully deploy its IOT infrastructure. As you know, WISeKey has been very active in IOT. We were the first company in the world developing the intelligent watch, the Bulgari watch that connects to the internet. There is something like 50 billion wearables to be connected to the internet in the next 5 years. It's already 1.2 billion mobiles connected, emerging to 6 billion. And the opportunity is now to establish a strong authentication in each of those devices. The problem is that more devices we put on the internet, more difficulties we have in ensuring that those devices are secure. Cybersecurity threats are now expanding from personal data of individuals into objects. Imagine the issue of having an infrastructure where 50 billion objects connected with the internet do not have security. So during the last months, WISeKey has registered a new patent, both in Switzerland and now in the United States, that allows each of those objects to have its own identity. It's basically like a passport of an object. The object with that identity is able to establish a relation with the internet, connect online, verifies that that identity is recognized by the backend platform, and if that has happened, the object can then establish secure transactions between themselves objects or between the objects and the platform. The uses are endless. In Switzerland, we have already connected 1 million watches. We are expanding out to wearables. We are also expanding out to smart cities. WISeKey was very active during the Bloomberg London conference of a smart city, where again we demonstrated how this technology connects the city. The beautiful of that is that we also added into the technology layer new concepts like a blockchain. In the futures, the smart devices that use our technology will be able, when they are attacked, to defend themselves. So the device will recognize that it has been attacked. Because the device has an identity, it will be allowing the other device to know how they are handling that attack. So there will be a peer-to-peer synchronization of artificial intelligence at the device level that allows the other device to benefit from the way that specific device is defending the internet. That blockchain is the only company in the world doing that, applying blockchains to cybersecurity, avoids the need to centralize data in back-end processes. So if you are in a situation where you attack an organization, the easiest way to attack an organization would be to attack the backend. With that, security is decentralized at the object level, and this is something which is very important. So the operations of WISeKey during this year in the United States established strategic partnerships with companies that they are deploying very large amount of IoT products. The good thing is that in many cases, those IoT products are produced by manufacturers who do not have a cybersecurity consciousness, and WISeKey fulfills that gap. The possibility also, obviously, to extend that to personal security, WISeKey with WISeID, which is the application that you can download from the internet, allows not only to secure devices, but also to secure personal data at the individual level. So I'm going to just make a demonstration on how a watch connects to my mobile phone, and how with an IoT object, which is a connected watch, I can access to my personal data on an encrypted cloud where I can, through the watch, decrypt all the communication towards the cloud and from the